You've all eaten microwave popcorn, I can tell, right? So when you first bring it out of the microwave, why doesn't it get all soggy and just melt through? We coat the inside of the bag with PFAS so that it stays steam on one side and dry paper on the other side. And in this country, 100% of anything you throw away goes in the landfill. And in 60 days, that paper bag dissolves completely. And all that PFAS leaches into the landfill leachate, which goes into the drinking water or into the surface water or into the irrigation water, which means we all eat it for the next 1,000 years. They don't invite me to parties anymore, but that's okay.
PFAS, per- and polyfluorinated alkyl substances, even in minute traces, can be very toxic, and they're all persistent. They're the forever chemicals. To be able to measure them currently, you need a very sophisticated instrument, and you need to do it chemically, and it takes hours, literally hours, to do. We developed a technique that is a rapid method for screening for them. We can tell you if there's no fluorine, there's no PFAS. And that big blue tank that you see is the accelerator. And that proton beam is then directed through a series of magnets that turn it down whichever particular beam line we like, sort of like a railway switchyard, you just move them. But if we put a target about an inch away, all the beam will hit that target, and any fluorine in that target will show up. And in the resulting gamma rays, we can identify exactly how much fluorine is there. And we use that as a measure of how much PFAS could be present. PFAS is becoming the largest environmental problem the U.S. has ever faced, and that cleanup cost is going to be tremendous. We'll need to know where are the PFAS now and what will it be in 6 months or a year. So anything that can make that process go quicker or save time or anything that can do it for less money is going to be really advantageous and actually a game changer.